And welcome to the review of informed Carlos Tevez. He plays for Juventus in the Serie A. He has a high attacking work rate and high defensive work rate. He's got a 3-star weak foot and 3-star skills. So looking at his in-games, his standouts are his 92 balance, 90 reactions, 90 ball control, 89 dribbling. We've also included the upgrades from his non-inform as well as a comparison, so you can always pause for a close look at his stats now. So this is the team we used him in, a 3-5-2 Serie A team, with inform Tevez up top with Higuain. So Tevez has got amazing dribbling and ball control, which we all know is so important in this year's FIFA. He's got 90 ball control and 89 dribbling, so he's got amazing tight dribbling. The ball stays really close to his feet when he's dribbling. When he's in a tight spot, when the defenders are swarming him, he's got that tight dribble, which can open up a lot of space for creating chances or getting that vital shot away. That's a big plus for Tevez's game, is his brilliant dribbling. And he is no slouch either, he's got 87 pace and 88 acceleration, so he is going to be pulling away from defenders. If you get a clear run on a through ball, he is going to be away. When he does get into position, his shooting is clinical as well. He was finishing everything inside the box, anything that came to him, he was slotting away. He's got great shooting as well, he's got great long shots. Also, as a massive plus, he has got the outside of the foot shot and finesse shot trait as well, so he can finish in almost any situation. But we do have a decent finesse shot in the box, just on the edge of the box there. So he does have a cracking long shot, as we said as well, especially with his outside of the foot. Lashes it from outside of the box, curls up, curls around, and straight into the top corner, past the keeper. Keeper had no chance. So cracking long shots to go along with his clinical finishing as well. He's got great shooting all around. Along with his shooting as well, he's got a decent free kick. We backed him on a free kick quite a way out as well. And he just lashed it in, and it's straight past Petr Cech as well, of all people. So he's not just lashing it in against a crappy bronze starter keeper. He is actually coming up against a decent keeper, and he manages to get a quite actually good free kick as well. So another string to Tevez's bow there. Now, the only problems with Tevez are his work rates and his heading. While he was making great runs in attack, sometimes he does drift into midfield, but the only advantage to this is he does have 89 aggression, so he can battle to win the ball back as well. And his heading is due to his lack of height. We didn't really get to a single ball with Tevez, so it's best to pair him up with a taller striker, like, say, Higuain, who's going to be the ball winner. So let's have a look at Tevez's performance stats. So in 10 games, we scored 15 goals and got 3 assists. All of his stats are down the left-hand side, goals are on the right. There's also a position map bottom right showing all goals and assists as well. So overall, we're going to give Tevez a 9 out of 10. Amazing player, with great pace, with lethal finishing. He's got amazing dribble, just a few little niggles with his work rates. It doesn't really detract from how much of a really good player he actually is. Easily the best striker so far in the Serie A. Highly recommend that you go out and get him if you've got the coins and you're making a Serie A team. He's a must buy if you can get him. He's truly amazing. So finally, on to positives and negatives. Positives are he's got amazing dribbling, he's got great finishing, as I say, he's got good pace as well, he's got good agility and these traits as well. He's got the outside of the foot and finesse shot trait as well. So only negatives are high work rates, was drifting slightly into midfield, 3-star skill, 3-star weak foot, neither in or there, but it'll be a lot better with 4-4. And his heading, as we said, probably due to his height as well. And he has a poor heading start. Was not getting to many headers, so don't be expecting to win a lot of ball for you. So hopefully go out and try him if you can afford him. Easily one of the best players so far we've tried this FIFA 15. Hopefully you enjoyed the review. Hopefully you go out and try him. So thanks a lot for watching, lads. Please leave a like if you did enjoy the review, and please subscribe if you are new. We've got plenty of stuff coming up, loads of reviews, loads of squad builders, so stay tuned for all that, and cheers lads, peace.